Hello guys, how are you?
Hello.
Good to have you here in Warsaw. We are very happy that it's happening, that you're coming here to our Erden studio, originally. So, and of course, we are very, very happy to have you in our Erden's family. I hope you enjoy it also.
Thank you very much.
We make some short interviews with all of our teachers because we've got a lot of questions that our subscribers are sending to us. And we choose some of them to show the audience a little bit closer your personality and how it's everything starts. So that's the first question that we already get it. Actually, how it start? When you start to dance? When was the first time that you were coming to the dance floor and you decide, okay, now we will be our dancers?
By me, it was very easy actually, because I was very, very young. I was four years old, and my mom brought me to the dance floor.
You didn't know.
And I also did a little bit of gymnastics, but after I chose for dancing because I felt better. My mom like very fast asked me, what do you like more? And I say dancing I like more, and I continue the dancing. So I was very small to decide, but when I start to realize that I like this, I was probably 7 years old, something like this.
And I started when I was 7.
Oh.
So when she realized that you really like dancing, I started.
Then you find her, in her mind.
But I think I realized a little bit later also, like starting 7, realized probably 11 that this will gonna be my life.
And you start with competitive dancing also in kids' age, yeah?
Yeah, straight away. I mean, come prepare for the first competition where the club was going. Mm-hmm. So then you go with.
Also, we didn't really have, when we started to dance, these categories, B, A, C, C class, and all these kind
it
of
was
things.
Open.
We had open everybody mm-hmm. together. So it was really hard for us beginners to be in front because like was good couples mm-hmm. already experienced. Yeah.
And when you decide to be one of the best dancers in the world?
I think these people decided for us, not really, we decided.
We decided to be very good dancers.
Yes.
About the positions generally, the placings, you cannot really decide. This is decided from the outside. But we decided, I think, when we realized that this is our career, respectively. So we're 7 years old and me with 11, we decided we want to be great dancers.
So it was never a goal for you? It was coming naturally, or how was it? Because, you know, some of the people, they are like, they start to dancing, they are thinking, okay, my dream is to be like somebody. And
I think I was not that stressed about, for example, title to win or something. I had always small target in front of me. Like I started to dance in Ukraine and I wanted to win the Ukrainian championship. Mm-hmm. Then I wanted forward, more high. You know, and I think it's normal for any person, I think, or a sportsman to achieve some target and go forward because it's never enough. So when you achieve something, you want something more. And this is what was with me, I think. I didn't realize this when I was 7 that I want to be the world champion. I didn't really care about that so much, but I wanted to be better than my friend, or I wanted to be better than my competitor and so on.
Yeah, now with, so it's small steps.
With 12, I think I wanted to be world champion. With 12, but exclusively adults or professional. I remember that. So,
so there was a very clear recall.
Yes, but it was in the background. I think the most thing what we decided on is to be great dancers.
And now, because you are still compete, what is the goal now?
For sure, great dancing. Because I mean, we will still have several years in front of us, but we are not youth anymore. So thinking about that, I think, is what the people remind after your career.
Yeah, appreciation of the people remaining in their mind. And one more thing for sure, I would like to stop my dancing career in a way, competitive dancing career, feeling that this is enough. Mm-hmm. This is enough. Not to always stop and then to say, I could actually dance one more year, or I could actually dance this competition and that. So I would like to come to the point that I will say this is enough. Mm-hmm. I'm fine. Yeah. For sure, I was still gonna practice in the hall. I was not gonna compete, but Because I love so much dancing, I will still practice. But probably I would not wish anymore that stress on the competition and all different things which actually we experience as active dancers. Mm-hmm.
And did you have any things like that that you thought about it? Who will you be if you will be not a dancer?
I think because we are coming from such a countries as Romania and Ukraine, I think we can do anything. I mean, we are so much learning fast, and if we want something, we will kill it. Like, we will do it till the end. Like, if I have a dream, if I have a target, I will not stop till I will not achieve this. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't matter what it will be. It can be cooking, it can be business, it can be, I don't know, fashion, it can be anything. But if I really put in front of me target, I will gonna put all myself inside of that thing to achieve that.
Yeah.
Did you regret anything from your past?
Never. I think everything what I had in my life, difficult moments and of course positive moments, it helped me to be the person who I am today.
Yeah, but also regretting, I mean, what to regret, because certain things happen, you learn out of them, even if they are positive or negative.
Sure.
So then.
But this is not so easy to, you know, yeah, to mean, know that. Yeah, that's all the things happen for something. Yeah.
In this situation, in our case, like, I mean, people know, some of the people, some not. So we'll tell a little bit. Cristina went away from home when she was 17, changing three countries. She went from Ukraine to Russia, from Russia to Italy, from Italy to Germany. I went when I was 15 to Germany, yes, without parents, also alone. So we were forced to see the positive thing of all our adventures in the life, yes.
Actually, my parents also, I have to say that they tried not to show me the real life till the last moment. And I can say that when I leave my house, of course my parents were worried because I was a girl, I am not a man, so it's for sure more difficult, but still I think I start to realize what is the real life when I start to live alone, because more or less I still lived in the pink world, because I had everything. Parents, if I need something, they make for me. So when I started really to live alone, and actually in the other country, it was quite, you start to get the life, like real life, what is it.
If you have a possibility now to meet you 20 years ago, what would you say to yourself?
To meet myself?
Yes.
I would be then 10 years old. Actually, in that moment, I was a little bit fluffy and fat, and everybody were trying to make me thin. And I was like so stubborn, and I was saying that this is in my genes and I cannot be thin. So I would probably say to myself, hey girl, actually you can be thin, and you will see in 1 year you managed to probably just that.
And you?
Wow.
Good
this
question.
Is actually a good question.
You have you wanted a question like that, so you're welcome.
I was actually quite a bully when I was small. Yes, so this is another secret. So I would say to myself, be careful, in 1 year somebody will beat you really strong, because after 1 year I got beaten up. Yes, and from an older guy, of course. But anyway, yeah, this was the first thing which would come into my mind.
Do you have, guys, any special formula or any secrets to become a really top dancer?
You just, probably one sentence, you need to love it. You need to love it. If you don't love it, I think it's heavy, because you will search for shortcuts. Searching for shortcuts, I mean, for an artist, it's quite heavy. If you want to be really, really good. Mm-hmm. I mean, really good. Not just having small targets, going from comp to comp. Need to really love it. With the love comes a lot of you are getting devoted to something, fully devoted, and then probably you're gonna reach the top.
Mm-hmm.
So this is probably the secret to love the dance.
Yeah, I would add maybe another two words: passion and patience.
Patience, yes, exactly.
Things which are also
that works
important.
In all.
What I think also, that with this love, all this stuff will gonna be there, because if you love it so much, you will then understand that you need patience. Passion, it's already included.
Yes, when you love it, the passion is there, for sure.
Yes. Mm.
And for you, what is more important in dancing, body or mind?
I think it starts for sure from the mind, because if you have correct mind structure and belief, then you can build your body. Yeah, the body is something physical, which actually if you work hard, it's there. Mind probably is a little bit more difficult to work with. But I am lucky that I'm quite strong and also stubborn. And yeah, I think if I dream also about the body or the coordination or quality, I can achieve that thanks to
your mind,
to
the because you believe.
Yeah.
To that question, I would like to add something.
Yes.
Body, mind or soul?
Yes.
One thing why I would like to add that, because I think especially when you listen to the music, the Latin American music, your soul wants that your body dances. So, like, it's everything interconnected, but for sure from the soul and from the mind it's starting and it goes into the body. I mean, you listen something or you see something and then it's not really probably that you think that you want to dance, but you get so much positive emotions from that you want to dance also. So
it was 2 days ago, I think we were practicing, Mario is coming and say, I practice in my mind, so let's try this. And I'm like, what? You practice
in your mind? This is good. This is really, I'm doing the same. In my mind, I'm now really a world champion. Not in a poem. Hopefully it will work in very short future. And one more thing, can you tell a few words to the young generation of dancers? What will you tell them?
I would say that probably I would better say to the parents first, because they need to let the children do what they like. And if the children are doing what they like, I actually doesn't need to give them any advice. Probably to be hardworking and to dream. Mm-hmm. And if you have the hard work and you have a dream, then it's possible everything. But it's important that you do the things you like. So then it doesn't really sound as a work. It sounds about something which you enjoy to do, because sometimes the work can bring the money, but it's fantastic when you also enjoy to do that job.
Yes.
Yeah, so this, I remember also in the school we had, sometimes the teachers were explaining us that it's very important to find the job which you will love, because then the time is passing.
You got
so
a teacher
hard.
Like that? Really?
Really.
Where?
In Ukraine, I remember till today. I don't remember which lesson it was even, and which teacher of which discipline it was, but I remember they were telling us find the job and study now to get the job which
that
you want, and you will love it and you will not feel the stress of working, but because you enjoy to do that. Mm,
this is really amazing information. So if that will be working in all the schools and the teachers will be really going this way, probably we will have more people like that. So mm-hmm. that's great. So for the next, in the very nearest future, what is your goal and what's your plan? When we can see you maybe in the next few months? We don't know.
This is our dream.
We used this situation, what we have today with the health of the world. Yes, we tried to use it as best as possible, and we hope we did the best we could. Having so much time, of course, in comparison to normally, we try to use this time to put it in action. Yeah, starting from the mind, soul, and the body also. Yes, everything: inspiration, studying, and practicing. And with that, I think we are ready to explode. Just when we will gonna explode, this we will gonna see in the nearest future. Hopefully, as fast as possible.
Yeah, I'm very excited actually, and I'm waiting for our first competition, especially the big competition as Grand Slam of the world or European, to see also our competitors, how they developed during this quarantine, mm-hmm. because we know how we work, what we've done, and which is our level in a way, and I would like to see what our other competitors are doing.
Okay, I try to invite them to air dance, maybe they show it, but I cannot promise you that. Okay guys, so thank you very much for your time. I hope you enjoy the stay in Warsaw, stay in the Air Dance Academy. And we hope that to see you very, very soon on the dancing floor, and see you then.
We enjoy as well, and we are very thankful for everything you does for the dancers, because we can also feel your love, and of course the team of Air Dance that they are really professional, and I think it's a good thing for all the dancers around the world.
Thank you. Yes. So cheers.